AutoLine Daily is brought to you by Bridgestone, passion for excellence.
This is AutoLine Daily for July 13th, 2010, and now the news. Nissan unveiled its new subcompact, the March, yesterday, and it's also known as the Micra in other markets, but that's not the big news. According to the AP, the company will build it in Thailand and sell it in Japan. Thailand offers lower labor costs and a hedge against the stronger value of the yen. But this is a big deal for a Japanese automaker to import a mass-market car into Japan. Imports make up only 5% of Japan's auto market, and most of those are luxury vehicles. You know, Japan built its industrial policy around automotive exports, so this is a sea change in what's going on with that country's automotive industry. Even though it will not make its official debut until October at the Paris Motor Show, Peugeot is showing off some pictures of its new large sedan, the 508. There are not a whole lot of details to share, but it will be available as a sedan or a wagon. Some of the engine options include a diesel with stop-start technology and a diesel hybrid. Peugeot will build it in France for the European market and later in China for that market. The 508 goes on sale early next year in Europe. The United Auto Workers Union is launching protests at Toyota dealerships around the United States in conjunction with Jesse Jackson's Rainbow Push organization. They both say they're working for worker and civil rights, but here's my AutoLine analysis. The UAW wants to unionize car plants owned by foreign automakers, and Toyota is its first target. It hopes to scare enough business away from those dealerships that Toyota will finally relent and not oppose the union's organizing efforts. The union believes if it can organize Toyota, it will be able to organize all the transplants and their suppliers, and that's something that could double its current union membership. Eco Motors, the startup company with a revolutionary engine design, is getting $23.5 million from investors, including Bill Gates and venture capital firm Khosla Ventures. The engine can reportedly double the fuel economy of a vehicle, yet do so at very low cost. Viewers of AutoLine After Hours will remember that we had Don Runkle, the CEO of Eco Motors, on the show last year explaining what this engine is all about. You can find the link to that show in today's script. You know, I've seen a prototype version of the engine undergoing testing at Roush Industries, so the development is well underway. And if this engine catches on, better watch out, all you other alternatives. It will not need government sales subsidies or any infrastructure investment to become viable. Like they say, you always get what you pay for. Wards reports that luxury brands ranked highest in the fourth annual Prospect Satisfaction Index. It's an auto retailing survey conducted by the firm Pied Piper Management. The organization hired 3,600 mystery shoppers to go visit dealers around the U.S. and record their experiences. Mercedes-Benz topped the list, with other premium marks like Lexus, Land Rover, and Acura following closely behind. Detroit improved the most, with both Ford and Chevrolet beating the average score. Overall, the industry's performance improved markedly, with 25 of 34 brands scoring higher this year than last. Good news for car buyers, but this also means six of them fared worse than in 2009. Mitsubishi came in last, with Suzuki finishing one spot higher. It's interesting how surveys like this mirror the troubles facing both companies in the U.S. Hit the link in today's show notes at AutoLineDaily.com for more interesting information about the Prospect Satisfaction Index. GM is giving Corvette fans a unique hands-on opportunity. As its name implies, the Corvette engine build experience lets buyers assemble their own car's engine. Future Z06 and ZR1 owners can put together their own LS7 or LS9 small block V8 at the company's Performance Build Center in Wixom, Michigan. Making this program unique, buyers don't just watch their baby's engine getting built, they actually do it themselves under the watchful eye of factory technicians. When everything's finished, the power plant is sent to the factory and installed in their car. GM's MSRP for all of this fun is a steep $5,800. You know, BMW is ahead of all other luxury brands in the American market, but it says with what it has in the pipeline, next year's going to be even better. We'll explain why it says that right after this.
Introducing Bridgestone's third generation of run flat tires with groundbreaking new Bridgestone technologies. Bridgestone run flat tires offer improved ride comfort, lower rolling resistance, and improved wear while giving you the peace of mind and comfort you need.
BMW is the top luxury brand in the American market, but it's a tight race between it, Lexus, and Mercedes-Benz. And BMW says it really isn't quite up to full strength just yet because of all the new products it has coming, especially with the new X3. Recently, we caught up with Richard Breckus, the head of sales for BMW North America, and asked him to explain what's going on.
We bring the new X3 at the end of the year. We're looking forward to having it. It's a fantastic new product. It really, I think, will match the consumer demand perfectly. Grows a little bit in size, a little bit more practical. I think it has more of a BMW stance to it. It's going to be a great product. We get it at the end of the year. And then I think, you know, as we go into 2011, you see the 5 Series at full strength. You see the X3 on board. We have the X1 coming. 2011 will be even better.
Even though BMW is at the top of the sales charts for luxury cars so far this year in the American market, Mercedes and Audi are actually growing faster, so BMW definitely needs those new models. And that is it for the top news in today's automotive industry. Thanks for watching. We'll see you tomorrow.